looking on how to make panels for your streaming platform on Twitch, YouTube, and Mixer for free. In this video, I got you covered. Let's go. Hey, it's me, it's Wild, coming at you from my stream support playlist where I bring you the best tips and tricks. And if this is your first time here and you want to learn how to grow and improve your stream, make sure you hit that big red subscribe button and tick that bell so you know when my videos go live for you. Customizing your streaming channel is one of the best ways to add style and flair to your channel. But it's not always just about style. Adding panels to your streaming platform shows to your viewing audience and new people coming in that you take your channel seriously. And this will pay huge dividends down the road with more followers and higher viewer retention, which is always a great thing to have. Now, when it comes to panel, in my opinion, there are three types of panels. The first one being a header panel, and it sounds exactly what it is. It's basically just a header, and below that, you get to type in markdown of information that you want your audience to see. I highly recommend doing this style if you think your information is always gonna be changing, because it's very easy to change it on the Twitch panels just going under the edit section. For number two, I like to call it the graphic panel, which is where you can make a fun little graphic that's a little more stylized that contains all of the information that fits within the dimensions allowed on Twitch's platform. It's a little harder to change if you constantly make changes because you'll always have to re-upload the graphic, but this is a fun one if it's just something simple like a Twitter or a donation one that's gonna have a great visual impact. And then last one are extensions. Now these are broken down into two categories within extensions. You can have plugins and widgets that can be from Twitch itself or from third-party services. For the sake of this video right here, we're gonna save extensions for another video because that's gonna be a whole thing that I wanna go over with you that's gonna be really helpful. Now, it will be up to you to decide what type of panel you would like to put into your channel, whether you wanna do a header or a full graphic. But a lot of people are like, Wild, I'm not creative and I don't know what to do. I got you covered. You're gonna use a cool program called canva.com. I'll put a link in the description below, but it's a very easy and simple to use program that's free to use, and I'm going to show you all the ins and outs so that way you guys can create beautiful panels for your Twitch, your YouTube, and Mixer. So let's go over to the computer. I'm going to show you how to use this bad boy. Now that we're over at the computer, the very first thing you have to do when you go to canva.com is create an account. It's easy to do and it's also free, but when you log in, it may prompt you to explore this Canva 2.0, which is their new website, but you can explore that on your own time. What you want to do is go to create a design, which is this big green button right here, which will take you to this page. Now you're going to see a bunch of templates that you can play around with on your own free time. But if you want to make anything for Twitch, like a Twitch panel, you're going to have to go up to the Use Custom Dimensions. Go ahead and click on that, and it's going to load up here the custom dimensions. Now, if you want to do anything on Twitch, it has a maximum panel width that you can do. And that maximum panel width is 320 pixels. You can't go any wider than that, but you can go as long as you want on the actual height for the box or the header or the panel page that you wanna make. But for this one, we're just gonna leave it at 200 because I'm just gonna make a very simple basic design. Make sure you click on that and it's gonna load up everything here in Canva's page. Now, it comes with a bunch of preseted loadouts here that you can take a look in these layouts right here if you wanna make any kind of, you know, graphic design or like a 1x1 or a 3x3 for different types of styles, but these are mostly situated for like social blasts. But it's also got a bunch of free elements here, anything that you need to load for text and backgrounds. But let's put together one basic panel so you guys can get a feel for everything on Canva. Now, if you're not a creative person, that's okay, because Canva's got your back with all these free backgrounds here. Everything labeled free is free for you to use. They do have premium ones down here that cost you a little bit of money, but 9 times out of 10, you can get away with just using some of the basic backgrounds and adjusting the colors. So let's go ahead and use one of these basic backgrounds. I'm just gonna go ahead and click on this one right here, and it's gonna load in this kind of teal green color. If you wanna make any changes to the color, just go ahead and click on the background and go to the top left corner. Here you can see it says pick a color and it has a bunch of defaults, but if you click on the plus, you see you will get a color wheel of any color that you want to use and you can make any type of adjustment that you want. Since we're gonna make something for Twitch, let's go ahead and do it kind of like a Twitch purple and click off of that. If you wanna make any adjustments to this background, you've got flip, which you can flip horizontally, or you can flip vertically. It's completely up to you. Feel free to choose what you think feels best. And then you've got a bunch of filter options. It comes with preset ones in here that you can click on and you can see all the adjustments, or you can use any of the advanced features, which comes on a slider, which you can move up and down to get the kind of style that you want. Like for instance, there's 100% vignette and there's no vignette. I kind of like the vignette. Let's leave it there for this example. Now, if you want to include any style of text, that is just as simple. Up here, it has all the basic title headers that you can put in, which is kind of like big, medium, small, or it has a bunch of pre-ones in here that you can do. Again, these are more or less for social blasts or like emails or Instagram or Twitter or anything like that. I recommend just using a basic header, which you can put in here. Since we're working on a small pixel size, it's gonna be pretty big for it. So we're gonna go ahead and adjust that. We're gonna hit select all so we can bring the font down for you guys and just bring this to like a 24, whatever. So here we have my text, it says, that we get to put in here. So let's just say we were making an about, whoops, I got my caps locks on. You're making an about me panel. Well, if you want to change this to any one of your personal branding or a font that resonates better with you, just go to the top right corner and here you will see a bunch of different fonts that you can pick from and it'll automatically change. I like to use something big and bold so it stands out more on Twitch's platform here. Here we can see we got a nice Black Ops one. Let's stick with that. That seems like a fun one. And let's fill out the whole box here. So let's go 28, go a little bigger, go to 32, can even go a little bit bigger there. Let's go 36. Now, if you wanna make adjustments and move this, just click outside of the box and click and drag, and you can move this wherever you want. And you can see that Canva will snap this into a location here that it will meet in the middle, or if I have another graphic here, it'll try its best to find that. Now, I always like to add drop shadows to my font, so that way they stand out a little bit more. So if I go to the top right side here, you'll see it says copy. It's gonna duplicate it right there. And I'm going to change the color of this one right here. Let's do just a nice teal for fun, or an aqua teal in a sense. I'm gonna put that right over there and then I'm gonna go up to arrange and move it back. Now, since it's still selected, I can use the arrows here to move this and now it's gonna have a cool 3D pop out effect, which is gonna make it more visually appealing. But if the foreground is too distracting or my background is too distracting, you can blur them out with a nice filter effect, which I use all the time. You don't want your background being more visually stunning than your foreground. So all we're gonna do is go and take up our blurness and we're gonna take it to like a nice like 15 or so. And that way my font stands out a little bit more versus this busy background with the vignette and all the lines. Now we need to add a fun little graphic. Adding a graphic is real easy. I don't have anything really accessible at the moment, so I'm gonna pull from an off screen really quick, just this little cute picture of a panda. And all you have to do is just drop it down here and it's gonna instantly load and take a little bit of time and pull up there. But it will remember all of the graphics that you pull in here to use at a later time. As you can see, I've got a bunch already preloaded in here. So let's go ahead and just use my little small graphic here that I can do that's about me. I'm gonna move this up just a tad so it bumps it a little bit there, make myself a little bit bigger because I'm handsome, and move them over right there. And I'm gonna push it back so my about me just comes right across. And now I have a fun, easy little panel that's about me. Or actually, my font's hidden a little bit behind me, which actually kind of looks a little dope because the teal goes behind it and then the white sticks out. But if I wanted to, I can move this back even further by clicking on me and hitting back one more time, just like that. So there you go, there's the forward and there's the back. I actually kind of like it that way if I was gonna keep it changed. That's kind of dope, might change that on my other ones. And there you go, that's how you make a simple Twitch panel. Now, if you want to download this, all you need to do is go up to download here and click download, and this will download to any file that we specify so that way we can load it into our Twitch panels here. It's gonna take a few moments. We're just gonna load it directly to our desktop there. Gonna click save and close. And now we can go over to our Twitch panels. Now to add any Twitch panel, just go ahead and click down on the window to hit edit. I'm gonna drag this all the way to the bottom down here, and we're gonna add a quick panel. It says, do you wanna add a text panel or image panel or extension? We're gonna add an image panel. So go ahead and do that. And right here, click on add image. And now we just either have to find or click over and drag our graphic that we just made. So I'm gonna click from off screen right here and drag it on. And here you can see I can extend to any size I want. As you can see, it has the maximum of that 320 pixels, so I can't go beyond that, but I can go as far down as I want. So I'm gonna go ahead and select that and click done. If I need to add any images to links, I can. If I need to put any descriptions, this is where I would type it in. This is where I would type in Wild 4 Games is the best COD player ever. Said and done. Let's add a little boom in there. That way people know I'm serious. And you click submit. And when this has a chance to actually load in here and it's done with the saving there, we're gonna go all the way back up and click done these edit panels right there and go back down and we can see our beautiful panel. And there you go. And you can make a bunch of easy panels this way. Canva.com is a really cool program to use. And like I said, use the link in the description below that will take you right to it. Now, it's really up to you on how many panels you want to add to your stream. I have made a video about this before on how to customize your channel to make it stand out amongst the masses. I'll put it in the top of the card right there within the video. Go ahead and check that out. It gives you a bunch of ideas of what kind of panels you can make that'll help you grow with your channel out there. But have fun with it. That's what's the really cool thing about having a Twitch channel, a YouTube channel, and a Mixer channel, is all the fun things that you get to share and to promote within your own channel. So have a good time and play around with the program. Hey, if you guys like this video and you want more helpful tips and tricks, please let me know by leaving a comment below down in this video and also giving it a nice thumbs up. And if you want to keep up with me and my videos and my art, make sure you follow me on Twitter and Instagram. And if you want to see me paint and stream, or you want to do some stream coaching, if you need a little extra help, make sure you go over to my Twitch account at twitch.tv/wildforgames. And don't forget to hit that almighty sub button. Thank you for all the support for all of you out there already. I will see you all in the next stream support video coming up real soon. Take care, all. Peace.